Lumpur. Two finals completed, three more to come. And next up is women's singles, and you don't get better than this. It's the world number one against the world number two. Number one and two seeds. Akane Yamaguchi is the two-time and reigning world champion in her second final here. She lost out 4 years ago to Tai Su Ying, who she beat in yesterday's semi-final. Ang Se Young, who has been in tremendous form of late. Well, when we look at the women's doubles draw from the quarterfinal stage, we were down to five seeds, six different nationalities, two from Chinese Taipei. That hasn't happened that often. Two from China, but four former finalists at quarterfinal and four players who have been ranked number one in the world. But the top four seeds made it through to the semi-final stage, and that's only the third time over the last 12 months that that has happened. But interestingly, it's the same four players who have been the top four seeds. It happened twice last year, all England and Japan. And I wonder whether the women's singles, the top four, are perhaps pulling away from some of the others. We've had the most open women's singles
final.
We've been treated to a golden era. But with Carolina Marin struggling back from injury. And Japanese players, Nozomi Okuhara, she's also been struggling with injury. The top four have been dominating of late. Here is the world champion, Akane Yamaguchi, in her eighth consecutive Malaysia Open, her second final at this tournament. And the number two seed, Ang Se Young, still just 20 years of age. Only her second ever Malaysian Open. A year ago, she lost in the second round to Han Yuer of China. She's had a terrific 2022, five finals, winning three titles. Korea, the Malaysian Masters, and the Australian Open. Now, this will be a 15th meeting between these two.
Of
the previous 14, Yamaguchi has won nine of them, including the last three. Last time in the group stage of the World Tour Finals, 18 and 16 in 42 minutes. So, Steen, sorry, I was looking away. Can you tell me who won the toss?
Yeah, Ang Se Young won the coin toss and elected to start on the near side of the court here.
That is very interesting, isn't it? Because we think that's the better side, the near court. Akane Yamaguchi, as you can see, is 25 years of age from Katsuyama City in Fukui. And this is her 46th week in total as world number one, her fourth different spell. Eighth Malaysian Open. Five finals last year from 12 tournaments. And she started a little sluggishly, actually, against Lina Kiersfeld to take nothing away from the Dane. And then beat Busanan Ongban Rungpan, then Mia Blichfeldt, also of Denmark, and reversed the result of the final 4 years ago by beating Tai Su Ying, who has won this Malaysian Open title four times. So apart from her first round, all other matches in two straight games. Ang Se Young, I was telling you, still 20 years of age, but she will turn 21 next month from Guangzhou. 170 is 5'7". And her ranking has gone down from number two to number four on the world rankings since the tournament seeding was done. Well, she's found it more and more difficult as the tournament has gone on. The quarterfinal against the Asian champion, Wang Qiyi, that was an hour and 17 minutes. And the semi-final against the Olympic champion and beaten finalist from last year, Chen Yufei. Actually raced to a 9-love lead in that deciding game. I think you were calling that one. steam against Chen and Fei. So our court officials from Hong Kong and Sri Lanka.
Ready to play.
Well, that must have been impressive because it was An Se-young who lost the second game against Chen Yu Fei. So when you've just lost a game to then come out for the decider and race to a 9-1 lead, must have been impressive.
Yeah, she erased the errors in the third game, An Se-young.
Ladies and gentlemen,
it's a strange match.
On our right, An Se-young Korea. And on the left, Akane Yamaguchi, Japan.
Well, I think the support from the reaction of the fans here is very even between these two.
Level. Play.
So it is the world champion, Akane Yamaguchi, far side of the court, getting this final underway against An Se-young. Now, was she wearing that heavy strap on her right knee yesterday?
Yeah, I think she was. You shouldn't rule it out. It's definitely not what she expected when she chose to start on this near side of the court. An Se-young.
All you need is a door open. There's four very large doors in the four corners of this rectangular arena. And that could enter the drift site.
Three, five.
I think this potentially could be the longest final of the day, Steve. So 51 or 52 minutes, the women's doubles.
What do you mean, like all five of the ones to come as well?
Yep. She seems to have very efficient movement around the court.
Yeah, yeah. I think she's good at anticipating the opponent's shots.
See, even time to walk back to the base position, almost like Li Chongwei used to do. Of the court has been explored by these two. Perfection. Plumb on the line.
Four of Yamaguchi's points that are errors on the back line by Nancy-Yong. She hasn't really scored that much, Yamaguchi, since Nancy-Yong got a better control of the length.
Being covered by both these players. They're pushing each other to the back, bringing them forward, making them twist and turn. And that is millimeter perfect. Longest rally so far. The Korean coming from 2-5 down to be in the lead at the mid-game interval, a 3-point advantage. Since 1983, Steve, no player from either Korea or Japan has won the women's singles title here. That was a surprising statistic to me. No Japanese players. In fact, Akane Yamaguchi was the first and only Japanese finalist 4 years ago when she lost to Tyson Yee, until obviously now. And only one previous finalist in the women's singles from Korea. That was Bang Soo-hyung 28 years ago, 1995, lost out to Susan Susanti of Indonesia.
There's a number of attacks to that forehand side there. Big miss.
Ends on six. Well, that's still significant, isn't it? Nice smooth movement. And so young. How on earth did Akane Yamaguchi play that? Accuracy. It crawled over the net.
Over. 11-15.
That one's landed in. She's challenging KOR.
Yamaguchi.
Outright winner. She was totally off balance. She wouldn't have got the next one. Yeah, lucky net.
That shot has worked really well for her. Fancy Young. Don't play Chavin in this, though.
Just get it back. She got it back with interest. Lands on the line. Oof. Maybe it hurts from the other angle. Two points away from the opening game. Make that 1 point away from the opening game. Perfection. Beautifully on balance once again. Yamaguchi wants to ask the instant review for that. Is wrong, it's game over. Oh no. Yep, she was wrong. Opening game to the number two seed, Ahn Se-young.
First game won by Ahn Se-young.
21-12. Well, I wasn't expecting that, I have to say. 17 minutes for that opening game. And this youngster from Korea, 20-year-old, is playing absolutely brilliantly.
She set out to do with the choice of ends. It's going to be interesting to see if we're going to see her in an even more attacking style now in the second.
Coach is Sung Ji-hun, Augustinus.
Umpire's chair and the coaching there.
Yeah.
Second game. Level. Play.
So one game to the goods. The number two seed, Anse Young, against the number one in the world and the reigning world champion.
And play a lot downwards, but I thought she would be able to use the full court. I think in the first game she was forced to hold back. I still think there's drift in there, and that Anse Young now is playing with drift. Doesn't mean Yamaguchi can't play it long, especially a flat lift would have a chance to go long, but I'm certain that she can play it full court with more confidence than she did in the first game. Shots and put pressure on Yamaguchi, and definitely something that the world champion has to look out for. Look at that again.
Nice challenge. Us. Match actually from Anse Young.
I saw that as wide. Just like the line judge.
Yeah, you were right, Steve.
Challenge
unsuccessful.
One challenge remains. 5-1.
Which end did Anse Young start for, against the Olympic champion? Because she may be a player that likes to get a good start to a third game.
I think that's the idea. That
which she obviously did in her semi-final against Chen Yufei, racing to a 9-0 lead.
And that's the idea. That it's better to play from.
Because an awful lot of players. I mean, use Victor Axelsen's theory, he likes to start the bad end so that he will finish, if it goes to three games, on the good end. Oh, perfect.
Young started at the near end yesterday as well.
Yeah.
She wanted to be a front runner.
Slice on that.
Yeah, and she's saving herself a step, because if she doesn't play that shot there, she's going to play the back line with a defensive shot, most likely. And they get a little bit more patient in the deep corners. Taking away the angles from Ansion, and then I think the unit was out in the women's doubles. Yeah.
She took it too late in her deep forehand corner. And it's a very similar pattern to the opening game, isn't it? With Yamaguchi making the early running in the early stages of the game, and then getting caught back up.
Yeah, and making uncharacteristic errors.
I think she's feeling the tension, you know.
Yeah.
All the pressure's on her. She's the world champion. She's supposed to win. Helping the disguise, because the racket head still comes through quite quickly. Longest rally of this second game, I think. Yeah, she's back level.
8-4.
Seven of the last, I beg your pardon, six of the last 7 points.
Yeah. And for the Yamaguchi now, it's to sort of stop the unnecessary consecutive run of points, but stop the run of points from Ansa Young, because she's scoring the way she's planned from the beginning of the match. And Yamaguchi is more or less...
Oh, that came off the frame, it still went over. Perfection. Cross-court smash onto the line.
This is working super, super hard. Akane Yamaguchi. And Ansa Young is anticipating really well. She's relying on Yamaguchi, relying on sort of one-hit wonders like this one here, and that's what we've seen so far, that the pressure has led to numerous errors. Disadvantage because of a lack of height. She can't smash there when she should have. She could have smashed, but smash doesn't have the same impact as a slightly taller player would have.
So hard, and yet Ansa Young continues to seem unrushed, in control. And the score's back level.
I think that's perhaps not so easy to recognize here and appreciate is the shot quality that Ansa Young is displaying. It looks easy, it's not easy, because it has to have the exact right pace and trajectory to stay on top of the rallies.
Advantage at mid-game interval here of the second game. Oof. See that again, I think that may have been worth a challenge. Oh no, it is clearly out. I thought maybe we'll just put the line. No, it's the right call.
Oh, get you, get you. Oh, 20 seconds. 20 seconds. 20 seconds.
11, 10, play.
Well, I don't think anybody can ever doubt the fighting spirit of Akane Yamaguchi. She will never, never give up. Off balance, as she played that one.
11-4.
So Young has been in the lead in this second game. Oh, this is getting better and better, Steve.
I think Yamaguchi needs to do a little bit more still to win this second game. I think. Here we saw how efficient it is if you can get a good deception in. But I still feel that it's Anse Young with the advantage. It's her game plan that most of the time is working. I'd like to see a cross clear from Yamaguchi.
What, forehand to forehand or backhand to backhand?
Doesn't matter. And I'd also like to see a cross back on these cross net shot back on these drop shots from Anse Young. At the moment, Anse Young knows what's coming. She's anticipating so well, and Yamaguchi's got to do something about it.
Lift. 15-30.
Very nice.
She's tensed. Returning the shots.
2 point cushion. Sort of errors to me is that she's got question marks in her own mind.
Yeah.
She doesn't have absolute belief that she can win this.
No. The shot quality in the right pace is not there. And whenever she plays a little bit more safer shot, then Anse Jung has been there to punish it.
Would love to see a third and deciding game here. This is intriguing. Thank you. 2 points advantage. Had 2 points away from the second game, Akane Yamaguchi.
And she's been prevented, and Sejong has been prevented from playing these cross drops, these very accurate cross drops that caused Yamaguchi so much trouble. It's basically errors from Yamaguchi that has kept Sejong in this second part of the second game.
She get that shot back when she was down on her knees.
20.
This one.
18.
How did she do that? Yeah, all credit to Yamaguchi keeping her focus. It's two game point opportunities, two opportunities to send this to a decided game. The net court. Here we are. Yeah, and it was perfectly legal. How about that for a net shot? One game point well saved, but not the second.
Yes.
It is indeed one game all
game,
in the women's singles final.
21-19, one game all.
21-19. 48 minutes into the match, and we will be treated to a third and deciding game. Brilliant. Wonderful band.
Seconds 20 seconds.
Well, what a final this is turning out to be.
Final game.
Some terrific battle.
Level. Black.
And so Young taking the opening game 21-12, but Akane Yamaguchi storming back with the second 21-19.
Zavasova. One love.
Well, in the semi-final against the Olympic champion, An Se-young raced to a 9-love lead from this near side of the court in the deciding game.
She should be looking to take advantage of this near side again. That's why it's exciting to see whether Yamaguchi has a plan. There was the cross drop. Attempted a neutralizing shot from Yamaguchi, but again, not the right quality on it. And possible for An Se-young to step up and punish it.
Super smash, but what on earth was An Se-young thinking about there, Steve?
Yeah, I don't know. She was controlling the rally up until that last shot.
And then tries the crouch defense, as if she's a doubles player. In one half of the court.
Specialized patterns of lightning in the arena here.
Three all.
Good, I can't tell you.
Ball
playing a drop from the round the head position and playing it straight is difficult enough because your body motion tends to drag it wide of the sideline. The racket head control on that was absolutely superb.
It was almost the same as the shot she played down 1 meter in front of herself. Good shot. Good shot.
That was too flat.
Yeah,
the cross court here. Oh, now Yamaguchi was stretching her left leg there.
Five, four.
She's okay. Definitely. She did well, actually, because I think her ankle began to go and she just fell rather than trying to save the ankle. And that's the best thing she could have done. Yeah. She's a tough cookie, is this one. Out.
Yeah, it went way long.
I was so worried looking at Yamaguchi, I wasn't watching the shuttle fall.
I was fully focused on the shuttle.
Short. Yeah.
She's played with more variation. Shots Akane Yamaguchi, even though she hasn't had fantastic shot quality, it still meant that it's not as easy as it was in the first game for An Se-young to anticipate her shots. As well, we saw that in the first game. So now the straight and the totally opposite cross drop shot, that's dangerous.
Yeah, there's more errors creeping in, isn't there, especially from An Se-young.
8-6.
Sideways drift on the first days is right to left, and you said no, it's left to right.
Yeah.
And since I've agreed with you.
I just haven't thought of it about it today, but
no, I think it's very little.
Yeah.
I don't
think
it's much.
It is definitely little. But if you play cross to that side where the side drift is taking it out, it's a tiny little bit extra dangerous.
Yeah. seven of the last eight points in favour of Akane Yamaguchi. From 4-5 adrift to 11-6 in the lead at the change of ends in this deciding game.
Something extra.
To the back of the court again. Every single way to the back. Oh, that's going wide.
The thing is, Yamaguchi, she's got more and more confidence as the match progresses. And she showed no sign of fatigue in these rallies where she's being kept at the back line.
Comes to an end now.
7-12.
Good shot. Oh,
yes. Do you know, I thought as they changed in the scene, Steen, I really thought, has Ansa Young got to take more initiative now?
She has to do that.
Of course she does. Yeah. Because she's been reactive instead of proactive.
Yes. Three good points.
Three
necessary points for Ansa Young. But also perhaps a little bit of complacency on Yamaguchi's side. Surfacing.
Yeah. Four straight points now to Ansa Young. Is that a sign of a bit of fatigue? anticipating the drop shot. Lovely skill, beautiful.
Sure.
Yeah, look at the body language. She's tired, she's struggling. Of a champion, you know, that you're not playing your best, you fight your way through, play yourself into top form during a match. And
I'm impressed.
Oh my goodness, great defense. Yeah, very, very tired now.
We said it at the World Tour Finals, winning the World Championship, your home tournament, and the World Tour Finals. That's knowing when you have to really set in with your best game.
Add to that the All England she won as well.
Yeah.
11-18.
Well, it's not over yet.
It soon will be.
Yeah.
2 points away from her first Malaysia Open title. What would be a first Malaysia Open title for any Japanese women's singles player in the Open era. Match point opportunities. Nine of them.
Match point 11.
Akane Yamaguchi has to dig deep to secure her victory over the number two seed, Unseyam. But my goodness me, I've said it many a time before, it's not how you start, it's how you finish. And didn't she finish quite brilliantly?
Akane
Yamaguchi in her second Malaysian Open final wins her first
11.
Title. At this tournament.
And a good job in blue, right by the two men in blue there.
Her two coaches.
Yeah.
Confirmation of the score, 12-21, 21-19, 21-11 in the deciding game. An hour and 9 minutes. What a fabulous final. Yes, the final rally.
Congratulations for winning the final match, Akane. Maybe you can tell us, how does it feel
first
being the Malaysian
of the
Open
year,
champion?
The first tournament of the year.
So, 優勝おめでとうございます. So, Malaysia 大会で優勝して, 今の気持ちはどうですか?
はい, たくさんのお客さんの前でこうやって優勝することができて、とても嬉しいです.
I'm so happy because I could be in front of the many audience.
Okay, looking at the match, you lost the first game but came back and won the second and third. What changed after the first game?
1 ゲーム目では惜しくも負けてしまいましたが、2、3ゲーム目、3ゲーム目でどのように戦い方を変えましたか？
とにかく我慢しようと思ってラリーを長く続けることを意識してプレーしました。
I just did my best to do the long rally and、I did my best.
ありがとう。
Presentation for the women's singles finals coming up in just a moment. For Akane Yamaguchi, it's a 22nd career title and a 4th Super 1000 title.Quite amazing, Thurstein, to think that Ansa Young is still only 20 years of age. I know she's going to turn 21 next month, but what an awesome talent.
Yeah.
And if she gets a bit stronger, her movement is already good. She's already got some good skills. I thought that she was looking a little bit tired at the end, but when she gets a bit stronger, physically and stamina-wise as well.
Yeah, and she's got this...fantastic eye for the game, reads the match so well.
Runner-up, An Se-young of Korea.
An Se-young.
Champion.
Third time she's had to settle for second best at a Super 1000 event. But for Akane Yamaguchi.
With a great pleasure,
the Malaysian Open title to add to her list of achievements, a 4th Super 1000 title, a 12th World Tour title in total.
We now invite Ms. Leong Wai Ying, Business Director, F&M Beverages Marketing Sdn Bhd, to give away mock check to the winners.
Runner-up receive prize money of $42,500. And the champion receive the money of $87,500.
We also invite Yang Berbahagia, Datuk B. Subramaniam,Deputy President 1, Badminton Association of Malaysia, come Chairman Organizing Committee, PETRONAS Malaysia Open 2023, to give away PETRONAS Trophy to the winners.
Congratulations to all the winners.
Thank you very much, Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Datuk Sri Dr. Muhammad Norza Zakaria, Ms. Leong Wai Ying and Yang Berbahagia Datuk V. Subramaniam for giving away the prizes and souvenirs to the winners.
lovely to see both players with little smiles after a real battle on court. But all was played in good spirit. Huge respect for each other, these two players. So as Akane Yamaguchi, the women's singles, takes leave of centre stage, we look forward to our next final. It's Victor Axelsson, the defending champion and reigning world and Olympic champion, up against Kodai Naraoka. He's through to his first final while playing his first Super 1000 tournament. Welcome back to Kuala Lumpur. We're here for finals day at the PETRONAS Malaysia Open. Well, three finals completed and the current world number ones in the first three finals have all duly won the title here. Next up, we have the world number one in the men's singles, the defending champion and reigning world.